So welcome back, aliens. This is Navin Reddy from Talisker Learnings, and in this video we'll talk about why to learn multiple languages. You know, we have so many languages. We have C, we have C++, we have Java, we have VB, we have Scala. Why to learn all these languages? In fact, I'm not saying you have to learn all the languages, because there are approximately 10,000 languages. Can you believe that? We have approximately 10,000 languages available to use. I mean, you can just go to Google and search for the number of languages available. It will give you a count around 10,000. I mean, who creates all this language? There are people who have a specific problem with other languages, so they try to modify one language and they create a new language, right? Example, Facebook has their own language called as Hack, which is based on PHP. Then we have we have J-Sharp from Microsoft. We have F-Sharp, which is functional programming. So there are lots of languages, right? So there are 10,000 languages. Do we need to learn all? Not exactly, because only 300 languages are famous, right? So do we need to learn 300 languages? Not exactly. So what I would suggest is, every language is based on something. Example, if you talk about C programming, it is based on procedures, right? C++ is partially procedural and partially object-oriented, right? And then Java is object-oriented. And then we have Haskell, which is functional programming. So there are lots of languages which are based on different paradigm, right? So we have functional programming, we have procedure-oriented programming, we have object-oriented programming, we have event-driven programming. If you learn VB, VB.NET, so it is based on event-driven, right? So it works with events. So when you press a button, it will do something. So there are lots of different paradigm. So what I would suggest is, learn one language from one paradigm. Let's say, learn C because you want to know about procedures. Learn C++ because you want to know how procedures and object-oriented work. Learn Java, it will teach you how object-oriented works. Learn Scala, it will teach you how to think in functional, because I guess that's the future now, right? Because the world is changing. I'm not saying it will be only functional programming, but because of the huge demand in big data, we need to process lots of data, right? So Scala is something I think you should learn, because it will teach you functional programming. You can also go for Haskell, which is also functional programming. So search for different paradigms, like POP, object-oriented, functional programming, event-driven, and learn one language or two languages out of it. And trust me, even if you don't want to become expert in C, if you don't want to be expert in any other like Scala, learn that. You know, even if you're a Java programmer, it will teach you how to think in functional way, because Java 8 itself is functional programming now. So what you can do is learn Scala, learn Java 8, learn C programming. So even if you are a .NET expert or VB.NET, if you work on VB.NET, it will teach you how to think in object way, right, when you learn Java. So having knowledge of multiple language always helps, right? So even if you know one language, it is better to learn other language also. So that's it. Learn different languages, but be expert of one. You know, you should be jack of all the languages and master of one language. So that's it. Thank you so much for watching.